Dear students, I am going to discuss with you the steam nozzle problems. So every lecture will have a few problems on the steam nozzle. So you listen to the video and take a problem and solve on your own. If you have any doubt, you can write to me to my mail ID. So the problem number one, dry saturated steam enters the steam nozzle at a pressure of 12 bar and is discharged to a pressure of 1.3 bar. What will be the final velocity of the steam for isentropic expansion? The data given, P1 equal to 12 bar and the steam is dry saturated steam and P2 equal to 1.3 bar. So from the steam table, you have to take the data. So this is P1. What are the data required? HF, HFG, HG, SF, SFG, and SG. So P1 is a dry saturated steam, 12 bar dry saturated steam. So I take HG and SG value. P2, it is a wet steam. We assume it is a wet steam. You take HF, HFG, SF, and SFG value. So H1, enthalpy of the steam at the inlet of the nozzle. H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2782.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And the final condition for isentropy expansion, we know S1 equal to S2. Entropy is constant for isentropy expansion. So SG1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. Substitute in the limit, calculate X2, which is 0.872. Then enthalpy, once you have the condition, quality of the steam at the outlet, we calculate the enthalpy of the steam, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. Substituting HF2, X2, HFG2, the enthalpy at the outlet is 2400.56 kilojoules per kilogram. The exit velocity of the steam, V2 equal to 2 times square root of 2 into H1 minus H2. So 2 into 2782.7 minus 2400.56 into 10 power 3. Actually, in this equation, you have to substitute the enthalpy in joules per kilogram. So it is from the steam table, the data available are in kilojoules per kilogram. So we are multiplying by 1000 to convert kilojoules to joules. And the velocity at the outlet is 874.23 meters per second. So the final velocity of the steam is 874.23 meters per second. Now, how we solve the problem? First, you have to write the given data and take the required information of the steam table, calculate various parameters, calculate the velocity, and write down the answer. So this is how you have to solve the problem. So we take the problem number two. In a steam nozzle, dry saturated steam expands from 15 bar to 0.1 bar. Find the velocity of the steam at nozzle exit if nozzle efficiency is 90%. Neglect the initial velocity of the steam. So the initial pressure is 15 bar and again the steam is dry saturated. Final pressure is 0.1 bar. Nozzle efficiency is 0.9. These are all the data given. So once again, you take the value from the steam table. So P1 equal to 15 bar, it is a dry saturated steam. We take HG value and SG value. P2 equal to 0.1 bar. From the steam table, you take HF, HFG, SF and SFG. So HF equal to 191.8, HFG equal to 2392.8, SF equal to 0.649 and SFG equal to 7.502 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So the initially it is dry saturated steam, H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2789.9 kilojoules per kilogram. For isentropy expansion, the S1 equal to S2, you calculate HG1 equal to SF2 plus X2 and SFG2. So substituting the value of SC1, SF2, SFG2, the X2 value is 0.77. Then we calculate the enthalpy of the steam at the exit of the nozzle. H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. Now H2 equal to substituting 191.8 plus 0.77, 2392.8 equal to 2034.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the velocity of the steam V2 equal to 2 into H1 minus H2 into nozzle efficiency square root. So substituting the limit, substituting the values, square root of 2 into 2789.9 minus 2034.3 into 1000 to convert, get the value in joules per kilogram, and 0.9 is the efficiency. The velocity is 1162.2 meters per second. And the next problem, in a steam nozzle, example 4.3, in a steam nozzle, the steam enters 20 bar and 250 degrees Celsius and expanded to 4 bar. Find the final velocity of the steam if the expansion is isentropic, and second, if the expansion is adiabatic with a nozzle efficiency of 0.95. So, initial condition 20 bar, given data, initial condition 20 bar and 250 degrees Celsius, final pressure is 4 bar, nozzle efficiency is 0.9. So, from the steam table, at 20 bar 250 degrees Celsius, saturation temperature is 212.4 degrees Celsius. 20 bar 2 degrees Celsius from the superheated steam, enthalpy of the superheated steam, table number 4, table number 4, you take H1 equal to 2902.4 kilojoules per kilogram. Entropy of the steam S1 equal to 0.6545 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So this is table number 5, entropy of superheated steam. At the 4 bar, the condition of the steam, HFG, SF, SFG at 4 bar pressure. Now you, for isentropic expansion, S1 equal to S2. So S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. S1 we take for the superheated steam, substituting 1.6545 equal to 1.776 plus X2 into 5.118. So X2 equal to 0.93. Then we calculate the enthalpy of the steam at the exit of the nozzle exit, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, substituting all the values, so H2 equal to 2588.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Velocity of the steam for isentropic expansion, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2. So V2 equal to square root of 2 into 2902.4 minus 2588.5 into 10 power 3, that leads to 792.3 meters per second. Velocity of the steam for adiabatic expansion, so that with nozzle efficiency, so V2 equal to 2 into square root of 2 into H1 minus H2 into nozzle efficiency. So V2 equal to, substitute the value and calculating, 772.3 meters per second. So look at the value. This is 772.3 meters per second, and this is 792.3 meters per second. So for isentropic expansion, the velocity is higher when you have losses due to friction. So nozzle efficiency, that indicates loss of energy due to the friction. So that leads to reduction in the velocity. So it is evident, you can clearly understand that when you have friction in the nozzle, the velocity, outlet velocity is decreasing. So in this example, it is decreasing by 20 meters per second. Then we take the problem number 4. Steam at inlet to a convergent divergent nozzle is at 22 bar 300 degrees Celsius. The exit pressure is 5 bar. Assuming nozzle efficiency is 88%, determine velocity at the exit, area at the exit for the steam flow rate of 10 kilograms per second. So it is a convergent divergent nozzle. Inlet condition is 22 bar and 300 degrees Celsius. Exit pressure is 5 bar and nozzle efficiency is 88%. So it is a superheated steam initially at the entry. So from the steam table, 22 bar 300 degrees Celsius. Table number 4, enthalpy of the superheated steam, H1 equal to 3019.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Table number 5, entropy of steam, specific entropy of superheated steam, S1 equal to 6.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. At the 5 bar pressure, table number 2, you take HF2, HFG2, SF2, SFG2, VG2. So the exit condition of the steam for isentropic flow, we know entropy is constant, S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So S1 equal to the same value, S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. substituting and calculating x2 equal to 0.98. Then enthalpy equal to h2 equal to hf2 plus x2 into hfg2. So 640.1 plus 0.98 into 2107.4 equal to 2705.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And steam at nozzle exit, the specific volume, small v2 equal to x2 into vg2, which is 0.98 into 0.37466 equal to 0.3672 meter cube per kilogram. Now the exit velocity v2 equal to 2 into square root of 2 into h1 minus h2 into nozzle efficiency. Substituting all the values, you get the 731.5 liters per second. The exit area of the nozzle, a2 equal to m into specific volume divided by velocity, that is equal to 10 into 0.3672 divided by 731.5 equal to 5.02 into 10 power minus 3 meter square, which is 50.2 centimeter square. So the exit area is, exit velocity of the steam is 731.5 meters per second, and exit area is a2 equal to 50.2 centimeter square.